My name is Lucy Turner. I am an 18-year-old dance artist and choreographer from England. My mission as a contemporary designer is to help other creatives find their voice in what they're trying to say. We're all taught how to be the same, but we aren't taught how to be different. We are all artists because we're all human. We all have that innocent and vulnerable need to express, and being different is what makes us run, the human race. This documentary was filmed over 8 months and includes ways that you can wring out your own creativity through experimental processes. Clips from class techniques and performance routine rehearsals have been included. I'm inspired by so many dance artists. Travis Wall, Mia Michaels, Sean Liu, Lucy Valerie, just to name a few. My main influences, however, completely changed the way that I viewed dance. I was so scared to show my own dance style, but with these three dancers, they helped me gain the strength to be myself. My biggest inspiration is Emma Portner. I remember the first time I saw one of her videos, I was so in awe of a dance that could be so honest. I saw all the similarities between mine and her styles, and I just immediately knew that I needed to share what I was like as a dancer to the world. What I find most influential about her is the way that she connects to her partners. Even when she's doing a solo, you can really see her connect to herself. She's brave and bold in her movements, even when the gestures are so simple. And her musicality, her symmetry, her intertwinedness, it communicates more emotions than words can express. I'd been studying Pina Bausch as a drama practitioner for years before I realised that not only had I been directly influenced by her, but also indirectly, because she's Emma Portner's biggest inspiration too. Pina uses her experiences of the Second World War by creating violent outbursts of movement. Her frantic movement, repetition, gestures, they all really influence my own storytelling. One of the first dance videos that I ever saw was choreographed by Phillip Chbeeb. I just remember being so young that I didn't really know what I was watching, but I just knew that it was beautiful. I later rediscovered him on Instagram, and I was so in shock that I actually found the same guy again, but it just proved how much he influenced me, even though I didn't realize he was the same person. What makes Phillip so mighty is the way that he connects bodies through threading, making shapes and then just placing them in relation to each other. As a young choreographer, two of the most eye-opening resources that helped me in creativity were books. A Choreographer's Handbook by Jonathan Burrows, which primarily gives you ideas how to operate as a choreographer. And A Unicorn in a World Full of Donkeys, which is Mia Michaels' biography, explaining how to look after yourself as a creative person. Essentially, being a choreographer is being someone who makes decisions. When and how you're going to evaluate your work? Where will you start? Some choreographers start at the beginning of their work. I myself choreograph in a random order based off of the inspiration that I receive. Jonathan Burrows suggests that a way to work is for you to create for 1 hour at a time and then leave judging it for a whole week. Dance doesn't always have to be to music. It could be to spoken word or even silence, but choosing the right music is something that's really important to a piece. For example, choosing loud music doesn't give energy to your piece. Instead, it will actually make the audience notice the lack of energy in your choreography. A way to start a piece is to become aware of all of your dance habits, different movements and emotions that you repeat unconsciously. You can try making a piece with just your go-to moves and then placing them in different positions, and it can completely change the meaning. Analyzing a dance performance that has changed everything for you, whether it's on stage or online, and why it changed everything for you may help you with your starting point for your dance. Bareilles suggests spending 5 minutes to choose 1 minute of music, 1 minute of moving image, 1 bit of short text, and 1 still image, and then trying to find the connection between your choices. His definition of choreography is that it's about making a choice, including the choice to make no choice at all. My main tool in choreography is improvisation. You can really find your individual intelligence with just impulsive movement. What's beautiful is that when you try and recreate something improvised, it most likely won't ever be the same. Sometimes you might see a dance and find a move that you really like and you might steal it, which is completely okay as long as you recognize that you're stealing it. Majority of the time, it will look completely different anyway. Something else to keep in mind when you're making a piece is repetition. This can create a moment of recognition in a sea of change for an audience. Not only should movement change, but the rate at which they change really has to vary. Like, for example, trying to squeeze a moment into the wrong time frame can be really gripping for an audience. Stillness is something I'm so passionate about in dance. It really punctuates what you're trying to communicate. Experiment by adding space into your piece and then double the length of the space and see what happens. Seize any opportunity where you collaborate with another artist to interview them about their work and what their artistic process is. Disagreeing with your collaborator may help you explore more than if you were just agreeing, so explore all opportunities. If someone doesn't like a piece of your work, flood them with 10 to 20 more options. A misconception about being a choreographer is that you always have to know what you're doing. You really don't. You can always ask your dancers how they work, and that might influence you even more. Something to live by is that if you don't find inspiration in every 24 hours, then you have lost a whole day of your life. Mia Michael states that using what you're afraid of may be your advantage. When your hands start getting sweaty, butterflies cocoon in your stomach, and your heart starts beating faster, it usually means that you're going in the right direction. Everyone has this magic spark inside of them. It just might be more buried into your psyche, so you don't even realize it's there. When a piece is authentic and makes sense to an audience, they will accept anything that happens in it. You can't be original by trying to be original, so you have to be authentic. Ask yourself when you wake up, how can I be more me today? Figuring out who you are is a constant process your whole life. By allowing yourself to be vulnerable, you open yourself up as a beacon of insight and awareness. These two classes have been developed through psychological approaches. They use the brain plasticity theory that states that challenging and engaging activities stimulate neurological pathways. I know that these concepts will be hard to teach, and therefore I know that they will really engage students. The way that I work is by having an academic approach to teaching, a creative approach to choreography, and an emotional approach to dance performance. Combining these approaches increases the likelihood that movement quality output will be strengthened. This first class is conditional choreography, which is an exercise that gives dancers choices. It's an opportunity to analyze your brain patterns and understand why you chose what you did. The emphasis is on individuality and using movement to tell your story. We all have different bodies, so we all prefer different things. I've been in open classes before where teachers give you choreography and a concept, but they just might not match up for you. This class gives a better chance of telling the story that you want. Thank you so, so much for coming to my class. I'm super excited to be teaching. So first up, the fire exits are here and here. I'm like a flight attendant. If the fire alarm sounds, then just listen to me and I'll give you instructions. And if you need water at any point, then literally just go grab it like whilst we're dancing. So this first class is conditional choreography, in which you're gonna be given two options for each move to create your own pick and mix routine. So first of all, I should mention that I don't teach in counts because I think it goes straight through the music. Instead, think of it like layers and listen out for different lyrics, beats, sound effects, and musicality. This first song is called Pendulum and it's by FKA Twigs. And I'm gonna get you to listen to it and then improv in pairs across the room. So as a prompt for your improv, this song to me is about deciding one thing and then changing your mind. FKA Twigs is kind of an alien and I want you to try and refrain from doing regular dance steps like circular springs, because literally what do they tell you? Nothing. I want you to improvise like you're dancing in your bedroom, and when you dance by yourself, you dance within yourself. You don't do like circular springs. Be as weird as possible. Like if you just stood there and spasmed through your whole body, then I'd still applaud you. So we're gonna start. I want you to take what I've done and apply it to suit your body. Okay, so first option, there's a knocking sound at the beginning. So option one, you're gonna go ta 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 ha ta 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 ta. Okay, and option two, you're gonna tap your foot and go ta 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 ha ta 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 ta. Okay.
It really made you decide to stand out from the crowd, like to do different things. And I feel like in class you're never given that opportunity. Like you're meant to do everything the exact same as everyone else, that you're meant to look the same, meant to do the same, but with this it's like completely different and you're meant to stand out and be unique. I found it interesting how like, so you give us the two options and like loads of people do the first option and like only one person do the second, like how it varies in which people decide to do, whether it like it challenges them or it's the easiest thing they like want to do. Like it just depends on how people like mix all the choreography you've given us together. Like I just found that really cool.
Try not to watch each other. Like try and make the decisions for yourself and not what looks good on someone else. I want you to think, why did I choose that? And when we perform at the end, ideally, I'd love you all to solo. If you did it with someone else, you might get distracted. And try not to think about it as much, because when you overthink it, you absolve yourself from the music. If you decided to ignore all the choreography and just improv, then that's your choice and I'd applaud you too. Okay, so option one, You're gonna go, you forget, ta 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 ta, boom boom. And then option two is you forget, yeah? You're younger than I am broken. Yeah, that's the timing.
We were given two options throughout the entire piece, but at the end, everyone came up with a different dance that was so unique and personal to each dancer. And I found that really interesting and quite heartfelt, watching everyone being different.
Are you all okay? What are we struggling with? We'll go around. I want you all to admit that you're making mistakes. Literally, take ownership of your mistakes. Like, if you mess up, show me, yes, I've messed up, so what? This is a non-judgmental environment, and everyone's focusing on themselves. We're all gonna applaud you. And you know what? If you mess up, that's when I'm gonna applaud you the most.
I really, really enjoyed the conditional choreography class. I think that was really interesting to see how everyone's personality was expressed just by making these choices between these two different choreographies, whether they went with the choice that was a bit more out there or the choice that was a bit more subtle. Seeing how everyone had a slightly different routine, as no one made exactly the same choices. But even if they had, everyone would have expressed it differently anyway. I thought it was a really good way of letting people make choices, but having guidance at the same time. So it doesn't feel like you're being put on the spot. You're making your own decisive choices of how you want the outcome to be. At first, I found it really difficult. It was a bit of an awkward situation, you know, going into a room, making decisions about choreography and then having to perform it, but all the awkwardness just went because everyone was in the same boat. Everyone had to make their own decisions. I mean, it was a really supportive environment, and I definitely found that this has allowed me to develop my freestyling. And it's just about making the choice that feels right for you.
The second class is interpretational choreography, which explores how each brain is different. It's based on assumption and gives students complete originality to their own framework. I remember being in an open class before, which was so busy that I was at the back and I couldn't see the teacher at all. And I had to go off of what they were saying. And so I completely just created my own routine, which was different to what they said. So in this class, I'm literally not going to demonstrate anything. I'm only going to speak the choreography to you. But first of all, we're going to listen and get a feel for the song. So this song is called Love Is Not Enough, and it's by the band Wet. And it's about wanting something so, so bad, but you just can't quite reach it. Love literally isn't enough.
Thought that the interpretational choreography class was the most helpful out of the two classes that I went to. I think that this one was most helpful because I've never attended a class similar to this one. Just one singular word can be expressed in so many different ways, and I thought that was really interesting to see. I think it gave me more freedom to choose how I wanted to express myself, but with guidance. I think that the most interesting thing about the interpretational choreography class was the outcome, because you didn't know what to expect. Everyone had their own spin and their own style just from a load of words. Everyone got given the same words. I think it's really cool to see how everyone used those words to come up with their own movements, and I liked that there was so much you could learn from everyone else. No one's was the same at all. They were all completely different.
You're gonna spring onto your right leg, put your left hand down, and then swap. It's not about being right, yeah? It's about being true to yourself. I'm not trying to manufacture your dancing, like, teachers always try and get you to listen to them, but I'm trying to get you to listen to you.
It allowed me to completely decide what I'm doing for myself. And it allowed me to experience my own personal style without even realising. I definitely felt challenged because I'm quite a set dancer. I like to be taught things, and being in Lucy's class and being told that there's no set rules, you are the one who has to create the work or change the work, really challenged me as a dancer. Everyone had a completely different routine. You know, some people took it in a more hip-hop direction, some people in a more lyrical direction. It was completely up to the dancer. And it just really showed off everyone's individuality. And it was such a nice vibe to see everyone just expressing themselves with no care and just being completely unique. It was amazing, really.
Like, you're not immediately an artist when you leave this workshop,
but this is the beginning of you listening to your own voice, and I'm giving you building blocks and tools to do that. Dance isn't just athletic, it's about building you up psychologically.
It was different. At first I was a bit like, and then when we probably got into it, I was like, I actually really enjoy it.
It's quite hard to try and copy a choreography that isn't actually set as such, and like, you wouldn't get that in like a normal class, so it's like more of a push than if you used to just go to like our open class and just like doing choreography that everyone else is doing.
The challenging bit was that you had to, because you had other people around you who were doing different things, and you had to be like, well, that looks cool, but I had something else in my head. Even if you think that looks better, what you have in your head will express what you're feeling more than someone else.
In these classes, nothing you do will ever be wrong.
It's so cool seeing all your different things, honestly, because it's not how pictured at all, but it looks just as cool.
I just found it so interesting how like, everyone was just doing different things, but basically the same thing at the same time. It's like, yeah, kind of cool and unique. It made you really think about what you were doing. Normally when you dance, it's like, you get told what to do, you do it, you don't ever think about it. Like, the most interesting thing was how, like, you told us a move and we'd have to make it our own, in a way. So, like, you told us, like, really vague what to do, and we all did it completely different, and it, like, it was really interesting at the end.
And none of them looked weird or bad.
No, they like, it really so yeah. Good. Like a routine that someone had shown you and choreographed.
Yeah.
I've never done anything like that before, and I feel like if I hadn't come here, I would have never done anything like that before.
Yeah, honestly.
Like, even getting it to do it by ourselves in front of new people that we don't know, like, it's just a good experience. And just, like, for auditions as well, you were telling us to be different, and I feel like that's, like, the main thing as well. Like, just, like, helps us for the future as well.
Like Megan said, I've never done anything like that.
We genuinely don't have enough pauses in dance, so pause whenever you want. Like, literally, without a breather, all of your moves are like a sentence without a full stop. So pause, but do it with purpose.
Next bit, yeah, is gonna be a bit of acting for you all. I want you guys to feel comfortable with this, because, so the emotions in this dance isn't just, I'm sad. When you're sad, you don't have one emotion. It's like a heartbeat monitor. You're all over the place, yeah? I want you to point, and I want you to actually laugh. Like, laugh like it's the funniest thing ever. Like, I want you to go, ha, ha, ha! We take ourselves seriously so often that I just want you guys to just like laugh at yourselves. 3, 2, 1.
So we're going to film now, and make sure you watch every single person, because you have something to learn from everyone. And laugh with each other when it gets to the laughing bit, like make everyone feel comfortable.
I found it like quite interesting, so when we did all our dances by ourselves and then you did at the end, like we did certain bits similar, like I picked out little bits. Like what I find most interesting is how like you'll say a step, but you could literally, you could make that into a tap dance, a street dance, a contemporary dance, you can make it into anything you want, like as long as you're using your imagination and your creativity, then you can just end up wherever.
You won't find this in any other class. I thought it was interesting because like you managed to like think of something that's so unique.
You especially don't ever do things like that, and you just randomly did it out of nowhere, so I felt like I learned more about your creativity.
So like I know what she's like as an artist, but like I never saw, it's gonna sound weird, I never saw her of Scarlett move like that, if you know what I mean. It's nice because like some people may want to cater to other people's abilities, whereas you would want to push them.
I really did feel that both of these classes did challenge me as an artist. I really liked how the classes were structured. I thought it was so helpful that we had time to lay down, close our eyes and listen to the music and get the feeling and get the vibes. And I thought that after to get up and freestyle to it, it just got rid of any awkwardness that was in the room, pushed you out of your comfort zone a little bit, got your creativity going. And this was helpful. As soon as we started doing the choreography, everyone was already in the zone, just ready to go. Hands down, I would attend another class with similar exercises. I found that it really pushed me out of my comfort zone.
I feel like if it was with an ordinary dance teacher, I wouldn't, because you'd probably just be given the same kind of boring steps that you always would, but just different versions of it. Whereas you, like, it's completely different. So with someone artistic and creative, like,
easy,
then I would definitely come.
Yeah, I would, especially if it was easy.
I would love to attend a class like this again, because I personally, as a dancer, feel I don't really have a personal style, a different style. Being in that class really helped me to try and start seeing what my personal style is. And, you know, eventually I would like to keep doing these, and eventually I will have my own style. One thing I learnt from other dancers was to be completely yourself. No matter what anyone's doing around you, don't be afraid to be yourself. Like, don't hold back. You know, don't be afraid to be judged because of your movement, because you know the dance industry can be really competitive and malicious, but actually dancers are some of the most supportive people, and being around that kind of environment really made me want to be in that kind of feeling too and completely give it my all.
I loved how Amber, like, she did like, say like a classical dance move, say like a split leap, but like she changed it in a way to make it like unique, and yeah, it just inspires you to give you ideas for what you can do.
Yeah,
like improvisation.
Some people, they moved in a way that I wouldn't normally think to do it, like Lucy said, a move, or one of the two moves, and someone did it completely different to how like I would normally do it.
It was great. I loved it.
Yeah.
Didn't want it to end.
The way in which I choreograph is very much based off of instinct. Usually I'll just listen to the music and improvise, and my body will say a lot more than if I was just plucking moves out of the air. After setting a base of a routine, I then go back and improve bits and experiment with all of the things that really don't sit right with me. In this scenario, creating the duet with my partner Taylor Whitehouse, I'm the main base choreographer and I create like the original framework. She'll give me a list of moves or tricks that we want to incorporate into the dance, so I already know that in advance. And then we get together and work out what works and what doesn't, and then she gives me suggestions on how to make the dance more dynamic. The following video footage will be from me teaching Taylor the base routine and showing how we progress and develop it on from that.
We just seem to think the same, and like when we choreograph, we just understand what each other wants to do. Especially now with this second duet, because the first duet I was a bit like baffled at what she actually was getting me to do, because it was so different. But now like I understand her so much more, so it's a lot easier. I feel like especially in our old duet, she used to be mine, we had such a connection on the stage, and it's like you're bringing your friendship onto the stage. This new duet is a lot like deeper, and we're close friends, so we talk about problems that happen in our lives, and it's like we can just share that on the stage and help each other on the stage. So She Used To Be Mine is like very close to our hearts. I think we won't ever stop doing She Used To Be Mine, but I think we wanted to do another duet because we wanted it to be a special dance, not something we go to competitions and we're like, oh, we're bored of it now, so it gets worse. Like, we wanted it to stay at the level it was at. And also it's fun to experiment with new choreography, new music, try out new things. This new duet is a lot like, it's a lot different from She Used To Be Mine because of like the dynamic of the music, and has some harder stuff in it that we're a bit nervous for. So I originally felt uncomfortable dancing a different style when we started making She Used To Be Mine, because, well, we both wanted to make it a duet and we knew we wanted it to be She Used To Be Mine. And I remember her coming around my house and we were choreographing in the living room, and she's getting me doing all these weird things that I've never done before, and she's like, oh, we just want to experiment, like, sorry if you think it's weird. It probably is weird, but I mean, we just try it. And originally I thought like, oh my God, this is gonna look so weird. Like, people aren't gonna like it. But then it came together and everyone was like shocked at how different it was, but in a good way. And we went on stage and like adjudicators would mention how they liked the shapes or like how different it was. So Lucy's brain comes in handy with that kind of stuff. I couldn't perform this duet with my partner because it's just not the same. Like, She Used To Be Mine, I cannot do with somebody else. Because the whole backstory of it is that we were in a car together listening to the song and said, oh, I want to do a duet to this. It's like, the duet is so personal to us, and the same with this one. Whoa, do that again. Whoa! Oh, sorry.
Oh, yeah, that was good.
That was a good one.
That was a bit different.
Kind of encourage each other a lot, and I think that we both have obviously different strengths and weaknesses, and we just bring each other's strengths up. So like, I feel like Lucy has strengths and I have strengths, and like together our strengths are like brought all together. I like doing all dance styles because I could say I really love commercial, but then I also really love ballet, so it's like, and they're completely different ends of the spectrum. But I think in our duets, obviously Lucy has her clear style that she likes and differentiates from everybody else. When we do our duet, we incorporate a lot of styles into it. Because we choreograph our own duets, I think it's a lot more personal.
when you learn choreography off of a teacher, you learn it and you might love it or you might not really like it. You can't really say anything. But with your own choreography, everything you do, you will like because you're making it. And I think, especially with our duets, because we've choreographed it and created it and like formed the story, that's why it's so close to us and that's why people can see that on stage.
You've got a warm heart. You've got a beautiful, I don't know, frame.
Brain would just both come back on.
Yeah, that
would have been
beautiful.
Brain, beautiful.
Pick it up.
Goes on like that. Maybe.
Pick it up.
Ing.
And start.
Ing.
A second chance, you could go home, escape it all, it's just irrelevant. Got a warm heart, you've got a beautiful brain, but it's disintegrating.
So straight knees. That was almost it.
From all the medicine,
our choreographic process is like, Lucy will often go home and think about all the ideas and write them down, and then we'll discuss about them through, like, talking through the phone. We always have like an underlying story when we choreograph, so we always talk about our story first and about where we want to go with it, how we want to start and finish, so that when we do the actual choreography, it's clear to the audience. We always have like massive debates about what the story should be, and it's like we're so involved in it that it makes it more interesting.
I just talk about to someone else and they're like,
when you want to come out.
Yeah, kind of like that, yeah. So like, you're like, right, it said it's against the back. You proper like exaggerate it, like with the...
You want to, what you said you were, when I...
Lucy does make up the majority of the choreography, but if she has any gaps or anything, like, I'll help her out. It's just if Lucy needs it or whether I think, oh, we could put this here instead of that sort of thing.
Okay. Well, on the verb, I think you have to straight away start modding.
You've got a second chance, you could go home. Escape it all, it's just irrelevant. It's just medicine. It's just medicine. You could still be what you want to, what you said you were when I met you. You've got a warm heart, you've got a beautiful brain, but it's disintegrating from all the you said you were when you said you